everybody. Dang it. This is my second recording of this video, this vlog, that I want to bring to you guys, talking about the origins, the original origins of CCC, which is a comic company that I do, and some of the hidden things behind it, and I think you'll enjoy it, hopefully, if you stick around, which I know you probably won't, which makes me sad a little bit. It kind of just, like, takes away a little part of me when you don't watch the entire video. Because I can see the little red dot. It's literally right there on my screen. So. Okay, let's get started. This is Crazy Duck. Now, he might not be very familiar to most of you people out there, but to me, he means a lot. He's not just a stupid little cat toy. One second. And yes, this is a cat toy. It's not just a little stuffed animal. It's literally a cat toy. They you can, I heard you can put catnip in it. And to me, where is it? To me, it means a lot, to be honest. One second, please. God, here. So unorganized. Crazy Duck means a lot to me, because it was one of the first comics I ever worked on as a company, as CCC. Here is Crazy Duck, the very first issue. And at the time, I was very into Battlefield 3, so I put in a Battlefield 3 joke on the side. It even says Battlefield 3 joke on the side of the billboard. I think it's upside down. Who cares? I do. It was my reference, and I'm gonna keep it. This is one of the first comics I ever worked on. It isn't dated, but I can tell you when CCC was started. Oh boy, I can tell you about that. Sorry. I need to go get some water real quick. I got a big swig of tap water. CCC was started in 2014, late August to early September, around that time. At the time, it was just me, and that's how I kind of wanted it to stay. I was doing my own thing, making my own hours, you know, just, I didn't have anyone to check up on me. Did I just bump something? I need some water, one second. At the time, you know, there wasn't really anything really keeping me up to date, pacing me, you know, nothing really pushing me. You like this statue? Thanks. Thanks for your support, guys. And then school started, 7th grade to be exact. And one of my longest friends, do people still say that? One of my friends, he's probably one of my first friends, actually. His name is Hunter, Hunter Rune. Or BLCWA Good Boy, as most people know him now. And when I got to school, I was pretty really into comics. I was going to comic book conventions, picking up anything that looked really good, to me at least. Vietnam Journal, classics, not really classics, and mediocre stuff. And that's gonna play a big part later, so listen. Please. So, at the time, I didn't know Hunter was really into superheroes, because when I first met Hunter, I tried talking to him about superheroes, and some of his exact words were, those superheroes, they were tights. That's so gay. And I was like, you know, okay, that's cool. You don't have to like it, but I found out he was making comics about superheroes and just heroes in general. I need more water. So he was making comics for his own company, Dank Comics, I believe it was called. And I was making my own comics for CCC, and I wasn't really giving a damn at the time. I was just making comics for fun in my spare time. And I think I actually wrote about it for my language arts journal thing. At the time, I don't really think I had much access to technology, so I wouldn't have been able to make YouTube videos for you guys about CCC back then. So you just have to believe what I'm saying here. That might sound really hard for you guys, so listen up very clearly. I'm gonna talk as clearly as possible. So, Hunter's company, Dank Comics, and CCC, my company, we merged and created one company. And I realize now, and I hope I'm not offending anybody, this is just my own opinion. I realize now that I liked working alone, which is probably why I'm really intrapersonal. That's a big word. I used a big word today. But really liked working on my own. I didn't want anyone to, like, go behind me and just, like, push, you know? And then Hunter joined. And I was like, okay, we got twice as many comics coming out now. And at the time, I didn't really know what kind of comic book genre I wanted to make, so I was mostly making, like, superhero stuff and, like, really vulgar stuff. Like, bloody and cursing everywhere. Just because that was what I thought was funny at the time, and it kind of still is. For some weird way. I like macabre stuff, which is also a big word. And Hunter joined, you know. Years pass. Well, not really years. Two? Three? I'm in eighth grade now, so. Three, maybe? And so much stuff happens when you gain people. Like, we make toys now, we make more music. Well, I never made music when I was CCC. And from what I think you know CCC stands for, you know it as Cool Cut Comics. Originally, I named it Cold Cut Comics. I don't know why, I liked it that way. But I must have missaid it to Hunter, and he probably thought it was Cool Cut Comics, and it caught on, and I decided I liked it. Oh, but anyway, now that I'm far into my own company thingy, is that really all the way bled through? Oh, it's backwards on my camera. Now that I'm farther through CCC than I ever was before, I'm looking at you eye to eye to eye here with this. This is my baby. This is what I create. It's my majesty. What started as a little gag from the movie, American movie. Never seen it. I haven't seen most of it. I would enjoy to see most of it. But what started as a little gag thing from American movie turned into weird comics. And I actually put a little thingy down here. They're called Daddy Sodas. And it's signed. This is a more recent signature. It's more crazy. You got the CCC emblem down there. Down here is Weird Comics. And then you got CCC. And I made many more. I made this issue where the title one was about football. This one where the title one was about video game violence. And this one, which is some of the original files that were scrapped, where the title was just classified files. I made one about the Toman, which was a feature-length thing brought to you by the people at Weird Comics. And this is actually the first appearance of Adboy. And he's like a little running joke throughout Weird Comics that I have. And this one Adboy kills another Adboy. And it says, buy comics, ask questions later. I got this one where Adboy's soul is telling you to buy more comics. And so on and so on. And I realized this is what I want to do. This stuff. And you know what I call this kind of stuff? It's not comedy. Even though it might be funny to you. I mean, it might be funny to me. It might be funny to you. It might be funny to that guy standing all the way. Can you see that guy? He's all the way back there, right behind you. Tell him to raise his hand for me. This is the kind of stuff I want to do. And I call it mediocre stuff. Because I don't even know what that word means anymore. One second. And basically what mediocre means, I'm literally reading it from dictionary.com. It means, it's an adjective, mediocre, of only moderate quality, not very good. Which means, I didn't really put a lot of time into it. I actually put a lot of time into the first issue. And I do try to put a lot of time. I don't think you can see that. The one with the American hair. Oh, spell! Oh, God. The one with the American movie as the title comic. And I realize that's the kind of stuff I want to do. I'm finding what I want to do by experimenting with things. I'm just checking the time. We have 12 minutes, I think. So, it's been a wild ride, and actually, first issue of Crazy Duck was Crazy Duck in Wild Ride. I just made a self-reference. And when you work with, when I work with Hunter, this is not, Hunter is one of my best friends. Our friendship goes all the way back to first grade, so I don't hate him. Okay? But after school, if I don't answer his calls, it's just because I want my own space sometimes. I wanna do my own thing after school, you know? I talk to you every day. What could you possibly have to say after school that you couldn't have asked me at school? Anyway, if you talk to any of your coworkers at school. Not. I screwed up. One second. I need to get water. Okay. If you talk with any of your coworkers on the phone, they're gonna ask you questions about your work, and you have to answer them sincerely, or else your entire schedule gets screwed up. And when I talk to Hunter on the phone about comics in general, for some reason, and I think he told me why the reason is, but for the life of me, I can't remember. I think I do, but I don't remember his exact wording. My skull fell. And for some reason, like, whenever we're on the subject of anything that could be related to comics, he asks me, like, any question about what I'm working on, like, so, did you finish, Action CCC? And I haven't finished it yet, and I made it so long ago. I don't even know how long ago I made it. Are you kidding me? It's not dated? Oh my god. I thought I'd... Because I even put the seal of... Okay. I didn't date it. I have a problem with not dating things. So now that's not dated. I could probably check the archive. I should probably do that. One second, please. The time doesn't matter. What does matter is... Dang it, I forgot what I was gonna say. whenever Hunter reminds me that about a comic that I haven't worked on in a long time, it makes me feel like a little bit less of a person for some reason. Something in my brain is like, oh, you should have done it. You should have remembered. You should have worked harder on it. And that little tick in my brain just keeps knocking and knocking and knocking, and I can't make it stop. So what I do is my brain basically kills the tick, so it stops knocking slower and slower until it stops. And then I forget about it for days and days and days, and days become months. And then he reminds me again, and the tick comes back. And then you can't stop it. So what you do is you take your unfinished comic that you worked hard on for the first few pages, and you just drop it. For some reason, you just drop it. Because that's literally where I found Action CCC, the last place I looked for it. It was on the floor next to my desk. Because I didn't care anymore. Sometimes I usually take his advice. But I have my own opinions, I have my own ideas. Up in my bed, this is where I sleep up here. This is my ladder. I call it upstairs to make it seem fancy. Upstairs, I have a notebook that is called CCC Ideas. And what I do is, whenever I have an idea, I go and I get that notebook and I write it down immediately. Because I know, if I forget, I'm never gonna remember it. And if Hunter reminds me, that tick is gonna come knocking. And I can just grab its hand and snap its fingers off and say, no, I wrote it down. This is becoming a rant. I intended for this to be a 5-minute vlog. Ah, man. But I think the moral of the story, if there is one, is that when I decided I wanted to do comics as for fun, why am I shaky? It's probably because I just dropped a whole lot off my shoulders. When I started doing CCC for fun, I didn't realize it would become as big as it would, as it is today, because today it is much bigger than I ever thought it would get. There's movies on the internet for CCC characters, kind of. CCC has branched out into movies, into toys, into advertising. And, like, I think one of the reasons I stopped keeping up is because I intended for this to be a one-man job, just for fun on the side. And it ended up going like a bullet train right past me, like I missed the train almost. And now I'm on the train for some reason. This is very hard to explain for me, because I never really talk about this out loud. Because let me tell you something, when you're an only child, you get lonely. And when you get lonely, you start talking to yourself and people think you're going insane. It's part of the reason I started a YouTube channel, so when I need to talk to myself, I can talk to other people on the internet who will listen to me, hopefully. Maybe not. We're going on almost 20 minutes now. I gotta end it. There's so much I like to talk about. 'Cause I know there's gonna be someone out there who's gonna listen. But I just don't know who listens. And it when I made my YouTube account, I thought like, oh, it's just gonna be like, oh, you can put your movies here. This is where people will see things, and if they want you to do something, they will ask you. You can get an actual job where you can make films for people. And just have fun, you know? And there are some really good films that I've made that personally I enjoy to this day that have gotten no recognition. Well, the least it's gotten is like 10 people have watched it. I made a Boxer Boy, which is something that I talked about for forever, and I wanted to do. I was excited for it. What's the other movie? Antietam was staged, which was a short film about how wars were staged, if they were. It would just be a whole bunch of stupid people running around with foam swords, hurting each other, and spraying ketchup all over themselves. There's so many more things that I make that no one sees, that I wish people would see. No one's gonna see this video, yet I'm making it, and I'm putting it on the internet so people can see it. It's almost as if there's no point in making it, because now it's 21 seconds long, and I've accomplished nothing. This video is longer than the first one was. It's only beating it by 3 minutes. And right now I'm shaking for no reason because there's just so much I've gotten off my chest by talking to a screen that can't actually do anything. I really want to lie down. I want to do stuff that's vulgar. I want to do stuff that's mediocre. I want to do stuff that when people see it, they're going to get mad and they're going to laugh. I have an idea for a short comic thingy that's going to go into an issue of Weird Comics. It's so. There's one guy, and there's a Jewish guy, and the one guy says, hey, and the Jewish guy says, hi, back, and there's just like a moment of silence, and then the one guy says to the Jewish guy, want to hear a Holocaust joke? Oh, wait, that's not very funny, is it? Because, you know, that was very, yeah, I probably shouldn't talk about that anymore. But when I thought of the idea, I was like, oh man, this is going to be so good. People are going to like this. And now that I'm saying it out loud, I'm jumbled right now. I need water. I need to take a breather. Feel any better. And when I think about CCC in general, I remember when it first started, and I'm like, some people might have the wrong idea of how it got started. Some people might be biased against it. Some people might not think it's a good idea. And I just wanted to take a little bit of time to sit down and explain to you how it came to be. And now it's like a 24-minute long documentary, almost, that no one is going to take the time to watch. And the whole reason I went on the internet was so that people would pay more attention, you know? I was lacking attention, and it made me feel closed off from society. I wanted more people to see what my brain could come up with. Because when you're an only child, and you have no one to explain your ideas to, when they're actually gonna listen, a little piece of you is gone. And that's why when I was a kid, I was shy. I didn't want to talk about what my brain could think of, because I thought people were going to laugh at me. And, I don't know. even now, it's still kind of hard for me to talk about what I think is funny and or not, because now we live in a society, and in my lifetime, I've always lived in a society. One second. In my lifetime, I've always lived in a society where people of all races and all genders live together as one. We form America. America is something, a metaphor. So I think during social studies we said it was like a salad bowl, where instead of a melting pot, you can see every little different thing that makes up what it is. And when I think about where I came from, when I think about my heritage, I don't know what my heritage is. I don't know anything about me, my DNA, what I think is right or wrong. I think gay dudes should be with other gay dudes. But I'm not a gay dude. And if you're gay, I'm not gonna hate you. I don't know, man. Oh, man. My chest hurts right now. There's just so much I like to talk about. Even though I feel like no one's gonna listen. This is usually the talk I would have by myself in a dark room with no one to listen to me. But I know if I put this video up, no one's gonna listen. But somehow it'll make me feel better. Because I know there's always gonna be that one person. And they're gonna go on their computers, their phones, their tablets. And they're gonna see that I finally made a new video. And they're gonna be excited, and they're gonna look at the time, and they're just gonna walk away. Right now, I don't really feel very steady. I don't feel like... I feel like I'm on a boat, and it's constantly moving back and forth, back and forth. I feel like whatever choice I'm gonna make, it's still gonna keep swaying back and forth and back and forth. And I think about all the things I've achieved in life, and I think how much better I have things than other people who live in different countries. And I think about what I complain about and how other people would complain about it. And I think about my ideas, and I remember when I was a kid, and I couldn't tell anyone about my ideas because I thought they were going to laugh at me. And now I don't care. I like it when people laugh at me. It makes me feel like a whole person. Goodbye. I think I got it.